Well, good morning. I have great news and I have good news. The great news is I'm in the woods again. The good news is it's cold. It's real cold. It's about 37 degrees where I am right now. That's a good thing. That means little bushy tails, little chicken of the trees, whatever you want to call them, squirrels, they are going to be moving today. And it's good and early. You can see it's black as pitch out there right now. With the exception of a fairly full moon. Oh, it's almost a full moon. But yeah, got about an hour and 20 minutes until sunrise. So I'm going to have said caffeine, get geared up, and start making my way up into a ridge. Obviously, it's dark, so I won't be able to look for the kinds of forage and stuff like that. So what I'm going to do is kind of hike in, and I'm just going to find a good-sized oak tree or something like that. I'm just going to set up at the base of that and sit for a while and see what starts moving when the stone starts to come up. But before I get really too much farther into it, I want to say, hey there, how's it going? My name's Adam. This is GoTo Outdoors, and I'm happy to welcome you back to another one. It's going to be a good day. It's going to be a real good day. Probably only going to be half a day. But it's gonna be a good day, and I'll get back with you when everything gets set up and I'm in the woods. Oh, it's getting a nice crispy morning.
Well, it's about 10 minutes to sunrise. Plenty of birds moving already. Seems I've set up in a stand of maples and poplars. A couple of red oaks mixed in. I'm gonna give it some time here, see what happens. If nothing happens in about an hour and a half, I'll move till I can find some more oak trees. But it's a beautiful morning. Colors are all starting to change. A lot more yellows and reds than there was even a couple days ago, because we've had two good nights of frosty action. But yeah, it's a beautiful morning. I can hear one moving already. It's on the ground. Sounds like they're going to be on the ground this morning. There's a mouse. Just went on the other side of that log. Okay, then. There's a lot of undergrowth there. It's gonna make them hard to spot on the ground. There he is, right there. He's right there. Not expecting one that close that fast. First one of the day. Told you I heard one moving. There's another one barking over there. There's another one moving over here. Well, let's Let's go get them. I hate greenbriars. That is a bigger squirrel. That's a big squirrel. They're eating good in here. There you go. That's a big, healthy squirrel. Let's get back. Even if I hadn't gotten any squirrels today, this is a beautiful morning to be in the woods. All the woodpeckers around me. I think I heard what was a deer moving a good ways off that direction. But yeah. Lots of movement today. Sun coming up over there. So it seems I found myself in a stand of maples. Poplars. And there's like two oak trees in here. The one behind me is dead. Which is kind of why I sat under this one. Yeah, I can see more oak trees off in that direction. Over there. More oak trees, more open area. And up over there beyond that bunch of deadfalls. But even some more up there. Up the hill. There's plenty of places I could move to here in a bit, but I'm gonna stay right here for a little while. No. Ain't nothing gonna bug me today. I'm glad to be out in the woods. I'll be 100% honest with you, I didn't see that squirrel until she was right there. Right there. And I got her right over there. You know, 25 yards maybe. 20 yards, if 20 yards. Yeah, but yeah, if there wasn't any movement, I wouldn't have seen her. She blended in perfectly with the underbrush. I mean, heck, you could see the browns, fungus, gray, bark. You know. At first glance, when you usually see them in the park, they're against a nice green background. But out here in the woods, these little tree ninjas disappear pretty quick. I don't know how much practice you had playing hide and seek as a kid, but these little things do it for a living. And they are good at it. I can still very faintly hear one calling over there. It's not a bark. It's not like chattering at me. It's that high-pitched squeal that they do. It's a good ways off, though. I can hear one squealing over there. That's why it was squealing. That was an owl. That's the alarm sound. That little guy knew the owl was here before I did. It's right up there. I go this long on the face of this planet and I barely see anything. And in the last year I've seen three owls. In the last week, I've seen two. Something just moved over here. There it goes. Okay, now the owl's gone. We might see some movement. That was cool. That alone was worth coming out here this morning. You think owls and other birds of prey know when they've been busted by what they're chasing? Because, you know, I've just learned what that sound means from a squirrel. But do you think it's been programmed into them over the generations that an owl knows what that sound means? And hey, you know what? They got me. I'm not sneaking up on them now. Maybe. Maybe. There are a great many things that we will never know about what happens out in nature. We can learn a lot about it, but there's new stuff being discovered all the time.
Well, that was cool. Woodpecker just dropped a piece of bark right in front of me. There's another one back there. See, now that that owl moved on, everything's starting to move again. If I hadn't heard that squirrel making that noise, I never would have been on the lookout for something. But that's something I've picked up on just spending time out in the woods. Just little tips and tricks. You spend time out here to learn kind of the flow of everything around you. When it gets quiet, that's when something's bit off. When you hear no birds calling, no woodpeckers, no squirrel, when you don't hear anything, something is off. Most of the time, it's because they know where you are. But on days like this, when everything's just kind of, I hadn't moved, like I was just leaning my head against this tree, listening to the woodpecker, like it was boring into my skull. That was cool. But when I heard that squirrel call, I knew something was up, and that was cool. The one that was over there, I hear over there now. It's on the ground. Something on the ground over there. Sounds like that snap and thumper. Squirrels knocking things out of the trees. Because there's no wind right now, which means the wind isn't knocking branches down. Probably not gonna see it unless it's close like that last one was. That's another kind of squirrel alarm call. I don't know if they saw me or what, but there's two of them that are upset. And they're both in that direction. The second one here is pretty close. Nothing made that branch move. That was weird. I'm gonna have to get up and pee here. Drank a lot of fluids when I was on the way in this morning, and my back to either floating. Much better.
few minutes. I'm gonna pack up and move. Pretty sure I'm gonna move in that direction. Hearing a lot of stuff fall out of the trees because, hey, guess what? It's fall. Things fall and fall. A lot of leaves falling, a lot of branches falling. Like little twigs and stuff. Definitely one of those treetops keeps dropping crap. Yeah, that's definitely a squirrel. That is not a woodpecker. There's a little woodpecker on this tree here. Yep. Some kind of flicker. Pretty much all the motion in the trees right now is these little birds. There's a lot of them. Several different species, but they seem to work as a group. I got a squirrel back there screaming. Sounds kind of close to where I was. But that does happen from time to time. You'll have some that are pretty close. You move, they'll sit there and watch you. They'll watch you for a long time. Then when you get up and move off, they'll finally start moving. And that's most likely what happened back there. I wish it was a bit more overcast so I wasn't casting such a big shadow right now. My shadow's gonna give me away before a lot of other stuff will. But I see a lot more oaks over this way, so I'm gonna keep going this way. A couple big ones up there. Well, where I've been sitting is mostly poplar and maple. You know, like this right here is a big old maple tree, and it's gonna kill that. Ain't gonna be having no lantern flies around me. But yeah, I think there's a couple squirrels up ahead of me. That's the direction I was hearing them move this morning. There's more deer crap in these woods, and yet I very rarely see a deer. Is that a bullet? Is that? No, darn. It's old anyway. There's at least two right here. I don't know what kind of bird that is. There's two squirrels mad at me up here. There might be three of them up here. I'm definitely getting closer. All right, found my new spot. 11-11. A lot more open on the ground here. I like this. An oak tree, white oak, 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 white oak. Two or three red oaks spread in. So, My guess is that this is where I heard those squirrels moving around earlier. They're probably holed up right now, but I'm just going to sit here and we're going to see what happens. This tree I'm leaning against is another oak tree. It's a big dead red oak, but it's wide enough to block my shadow, as you can see right here. So we're going to sit here and see what happens. Percentage wise, this is the highest percentage spot that I've found all morning. There's a fox squirrel. There's a fox squirrel. He's moving super slow on the ground. I have not seen a fox squirrel in a long time. Not that I could potentially hit. Harry, I'm getting buck fever over a squirrel. Whatever, I don't care. He was dead silent. He was walking, he wasn't jumping. Oh, come on, where'd he go? On the ground. There he is again. That's a big squirrel. It's just a little too far away. Yeah, it's 40 yards of the tree he was next to. It's a little too far. But I know he's here. So I'm gonna wait. Yeah, that one's just walking through the underbrush, not jumping. So I didn't know he was there until I looked up and saw him in the sun. His tail reflected like my beard does. See, I had a feeling this was a good spot. With a 22, I would have taken that shot. The shotgun, I'm not gonna do it. I just marked that squirrel's location in Onyx because I have a feeling if I don't get him today, I can get him next time I come out. Fox squirrels tend to be a little bit more territorial than gray squirrels do. There's another squirrel right over there. He's on the ground. Yep, it's walking away. That's that fox squirrel. That big old fox squirrel. Okay, so he's about 80 yards now. Now I can hear that squirrel moving on the ground. He's on the side of that tree. He's going up that tree. Bro, see him wagging that big old foxy tail of his. Wagging it around in circles. He's just out of range. Just out of range. Nervous, but he's not barking. And now he's starting to grouse at me. Yep. See, a fox squirrel is something real special to me. They're not super common around here. I don't see them very often. I've only ever taken one out of these woods. Is he gonna go up or down? He's probably gonna go down and run farther away. Yeah, he's on the ground. Moving right to left. He's gonna hit another tree for a better view of me. He's at 44 yards. He's at the base of that little skinny maple tree over there. It's exactly at 44 yards. There's another one coming closer. They're both fox squirrels. Of that tree now. Where'd he go? Is he climbing? Sounds like he's climbing. Alright. That was a very bad time for that battery to die. Swapped it out. We'll see if they come back. As soon as that loud beep went off, I heard two scatter in different directions. So, that's annoying. I had a feeling it was coming up on a battery change anyway. But the timing was just not great. And I had that one in front of me almost in range. And then, gone. These mosquitoes and gnats are a nightmare. God bless them. Damn gnats. The fact that I haven't heard a single one of these fox squirrels is actually pretty cool. I've seen three of them. There's three of them right around here. But I haven't heard a single one of them. And purely visual.
Whew, it got kind of gnarly out here. It got hot. I'm wearing thermal bibs. Not a great plan. But that being said, today was a great day. Today was a really great day. Only got the one squirrel. Don't mind that at all. And I'd be fine coming out here and I didn't even get anything because it was just such a beautiful morning. Like I said, But I got the one, right, pretty much sunrise.
And then seeing that owl was really cool. Again, it's the kind of thing that I wouldn't have cared if I didn't get anything else, but those experiences are the kind of thing that make it worthwhile for me to come out here. It's really hot. Yeah, did I mention that yet? It's like close to 70 degrees, I think, which is gross. Considering I got out here and it was like 36, 37 degrees, according to what was the thermometer on my truck. But I had a feeling they'd be moving better than this today, but you know, the wind kicked up and the sun, you know, bluebird skies yet again. I mean, not even a single whiff of a cloud anywhere. So, you know, the squirrels are gonna find a spot out of the wind. Most of the time, they're just gonna be like in a crook of a tree, sunning themselves. I don't blame them. If they get up and get breakfast and then they're good to go, they're good to go. But those fox squirrels, that has me really excited. I've only ever taken one. And it was here, and it was way back in the back of this place. I've seen a couple driving in and out. You know, I've always seen them next to the roads. I've never seen any more of them up where I was, and I was probably a good, I'd say probably a half mile into the woods. Probably about a mile up the road and about a half mile into the woods. So I guess I wandered a good ways today because essentially I went straight across the road, climbed up the hill when I got here. But mark their location, and I marked the spot on the road closest to where that is. So I'm just gonna, next time I come out here, could be this week, could be sometime next week, but I'm really excited to try and get to at least one of those fox squirrels. I saw three of them. I saw three of them at the same time, so I know they're out there. And I know there's a whole bunch more just regular gray squirrels mixed in with them because that's what they do. These woods are absolutely jam-packed with these bushy-tailed little tree ninjas. And I'm going to beat them. I'm going to beat them this year. I'm going to get me a fox squirrel. Squirrel season goes well into next year. It's mid-October right now, so I got plenty of time. There's so much life in these woods. It's ridiculous. And yeah, going to be back at work super early tomorrow, so I'm not hunting tomorrow. Get a couple days off this week, so we're going to see what happens. But for the time being, that's about all I got for you today. So like I always say, thanks again for watching. Make sure you find a reason to smile today. I know I did. And yeah, I'll catch you in the next one. See you then.